last, we got to talk about this. Let's talk about the Green Bay Packers. Look, there's a team that's 3-3. They're one of the top contenders in the NFC coming into the year. I still believe they are. I still believe the fundamentals of a good football team there is there, but it's clear they're missing some key pieces. But good news for the Packers, there's some rumors circulating around that they may be addressing one of their biggest problems. I know you have the story on that. But before I hand it off to you, Packers fans, we want to hear from you in the comment section below. The trade deadline right around the corner, the 1st of November is the last day any team will be able to make any trades. Obviously, potential free agent moves are still lurking around. Let us know in the comment section below who you think the Green Bay Packers need to pick up, either by trade or by free agency, to turn their season around and be a top contender in the NFC again. Let us know who you want them to get in the comment section below. But Maya, what's the latest out of Green Bay?
Well, Nick, I have a pretty good option for Green Bay. Let me throw this by you, Nick. I'm going to give you some stats of this player. You tell me what you think. So what if I told you Green Bay could get a receiver, something that they desperately need? Yes, obviously, any receiver, good option. What if I told you it was one of the 5 fastest receivers in the NFL so far this season, clocked in at 21.46 miles per hour? It's pretty nice.
Yeah, take it.
Last week, put up an 89.0 PFF receiving grade. That's incredible. Like we said, a 90 is pretty much like superstar status. And that's 89, so it's basically just right there. Yeah. They go over 100 yards, touchdown. Would you say this is a good fit for the Green Bay Packers?
Yep. I mean, yeah, definitely at this point.
And you would be like, all right, Myers, well, we don't want to give them Devontae Adams back or Tyreek Hill or anyone like that. They can't afford that. But, Nick, they don't have to afford that because Pittsburgh Steelers wide receiver Chase Claypool did all of those things. That is who I've been talking about. He was drafted in 2020 by the Steelers from Notre Dame, a second-round guy, and he has been. They've been wanting him to step up ever since Juju left and kind of took a bigger role. And last week against the Bucs, he kind of had his big breakout game, so to speak. He looked really good, especially when Mitch Trubisky stepped into the game and took over. Claypool had a phenomenal game, and I think this is a guy. He's 6'4", almost 240 pounds, a huge, big target for Rodgers. I think this is a excellent pickup for this Packers offense.
Yeah, 100%. And the Packers offense, that is their main issue right now, especially their passing game. And you look at the numbers here, it doesn't look good. If you look at the passing offense, if you look at the teams that are where their rankings shake out, the Green Bay Packers are averaging one more yard than the lowly Washington Commanders in terms of passing yards per game. That is crazy to think about. You look at the teams that are ahead of them. You have the New York Jets with Zach Wilson and Joe Flacco, more productive than the Packers. You have teams like the New Orleans Saints that have gone through multiple quarterbacks, the Seattle Seahawks with Geno Smith, the Rams, which everyone says the Rams passing offense stinks, are much more productive than Green Bay Packers. And it's not just, you know, just their volume. You look at Aaron Rodgers, his stats this year, big drop off. He's at a 7-year low in yards per attempt, passer rating, yards per game. I mean, it's clearly you can tell. And Rodgers, it's not like he just went from being a great player like he was the last couple of years to a bad player. He just doesn't have the weapons, right? The Watson injury, the issues with Dobbs. You've got now Randall Cobb's hurt. You just had issues at the receiver position. It's just happened. They need to make a move here. And Chase Claypool seems like an absolutely perfect fit. He's big, strong, physical. You look at those back shoulder throws, the kind that Rodgers likes to make. He made a lot of those, you know, fade routes, back shoulders to Devontae Adams for a long time. It was kind of just drop the ball into the bucket. That's what Claypool's really good at. Seems like a nice, easy, natural fit. You know, big, strong receiver. They could probably not have to give up too much for him. The Steelers would be happy to move off of him because they have guys like Pickens and Johnson and Freiermuth at tight end. It just seems to make sense. It's one of those moves that just makes too much sense for a team like the Packers to not take advantage of.
Yeah, Nick. And per Noah Strackbine over at Sports Illustrated Fan Nation, it is a move that a lot of people think makes sense. He said that a few general managers around the league that have been spoken to said Green Bay is definitely looking for potential receiver help on the trade market, and Claypool is one of the receivers that they have been looking at heavily. They are reportedly quote unquote all in on Chase Claypool, and they think that he would be an excellent fit for the offense. So that's my source. I probably should have brought that up earlier, but you know, it is, as long as I fit it in here, you know. But I think this is very interesting. just like you said, we forgot one guy. They got George Pickens, Deontay Johnson, Freiermuth, and Calvin Austin potentially on the comeback. Speedster. Steelers are set wide receiver wise if everything pans out the way that it should. And, you know, if they could get a good haul for Claypool through the trade market, you know, it's a win-win. Bring Rodgers in a true weapon. Let this team materialize. They have an excellent running game. They need one more piece to kind of help out in the passing game. And then I think the Packers are going to be set. I think that the Steelers are happy with the receivers. They know they're not winning anything this year. So get another set of draft picks. Build the future. I think it's a win-win for everybody involved.